Scented, okay, I'm Pierre Binet, the director of APC, I'll welcome you here on behalf of Joe Smoot, who is the head of the Paris Center for Cosmological Physics. So maybe I could tell you a few words about the center, which was created by George when he was hired in this university 2 years ago. And it has got several programs. Which is the fellow program, where we have a certain number of postdoctoral fellows here at, mostly here. The center is four floors up on the fourth floor, but also in other labs in the Paris area. And this was one of the goals of George to sort of promote cosmology in the Paris area. And one of the ideas was to have a strong fellow program, which started 2 years ago. At this point, the center has five fellows. As I said, mostly at APC, but also in another lab in Jussieu. The center has also some other programs, for example, programs in the direction of the general public. Training teachers in the field of cosmology, high school teachers, or the more general public students, and so on. If I focus on the fellows program, it has become traditional that the fellows organize events, and this is one of the events organized by the fellows of the center. So maybe I should give you the names of the organizers, because this is really their event. Giulia Gubitozzi, Mark Jackson, Andrea Tartari, who is just standing over there, and Federico Piazza. So we're really the ones organizing this event. And from time to time, we have one such event. And it was decided some time ago that it would be focused on Lorentz violations. We had something like a couple of months, a couple of months. We had one meeting, one workshop here in the same room, organized by APC about Lorentz violation in the neutrino sector. That there has been news recently that there might not be any, or at least we have to wait to see if there's still an anomaly in the opera results. But the focus of this meeting is really Lorentz violation in general, and probably we will all agree that if there is no violation in the neutrino sector of a size, of huge size, that was seemed to be detected by OPERA. Lorentz violations are still a very interesting topic, and probably a more comfortable one if we don't have to explain such huge violations that seem to be observed by OPERA. So the focus of this meeting was really not huge Lorentz violations in the neutrino sector. It was more of a general topic of why is it interesting to look at the status of Lorentz symmetry and the kind of violations that one might be expecting regarding this symmetry and the status of this symmetry. Okay, so the last thing I should probably say regarding organizational details, so probably you'll hear more about that in the course of the day. I should stress that most of the organization has been under the responsibility of Giulia Vannoni, whom you might have seen when coming, who has been in the last month both the assistant of George. Both the assistant of George and the administrator of the center. And I must say that she has been really the heart of the organization of this meeting, responsible not only for the administrative support but all the organizational details, and even the artwork was her doing. So we'll express our thanks later, but she has been really key in organizing this meeting. And so, finally, I should, tell you that, George could not be here today, as any Nobel Prize, he's traveling a lot, but he's extending you know, his best wishes for the success of this workshop. And so we start with the first speaker, with the chair. You're the chair.
Yeah, good morning to everyone. So our first speaker will be Maxim Pospelov from Perimeter Institute in Canada, who's going to talk about Lorentz symmetry violations in field theories. And one thing is, I ask you if you have any question or comments to always use the microphone, because we have to record everything for the broadcast.